Turn your Bibles tonight with me unto the 16th chapter of the book of Matthew's Gospel. Turn with me to the 13th verse when Jesus came into the coasts of Caesarea Philippi. He asked his disciples, saying, "Whom do men say that the Son of Man am?" They said, "Some, thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus answered, said unto him, "Blessed art thou, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say also unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." I love that thought. Peter said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Not a dead God, but a living God. "That thou art the Son of the living God." It's impossible for you to be saved if you don't believe that Jesus died and rose again. Impossible anyone to be saved. If thou will believe that Jesus died and rose again, you believe that he's the Son of God, thou shalt be saved. There's no way to be saved unless you believe it. Here he was talking about, "Thou art Simon Barjona. Flesh and blood have not revealed this unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven has revealed this unto thee." Said Peter, said, "Listen, boy, whom do you say that I am?" He said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." Not a dead God, but a live God. I'm glad he's alive. I just had a little talk with him, and he talked back to me. When I pray to him, and when I read God's word, he talks to me. Clap your hands for the victory. He's alive. It's Revelation chapter 1, verse 18. Spoke to Jesus, said, "I'll give you the keys to the kingdom of God." And said, "I'll give you the keys. I'm he that was once dead, but behold, I'm alive forevermore. I got the keys to death and hell." How many believe tonight he said, "I'll give you the keys unto the kingdom of God"? Honey, the church has got the keys. Clap your hands for the victory. I love the thought he told Peter, that this bound on earth shall be bound in heaven, but that this loosed on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Otherwise, if you run into any demons or devils, any sicknesses or afflictions, I'll give you power to bind it on earth, and anything that's bound on earth, or to agree on any one thing, it shall come to pass. It's bound on earth. It's bound in heaven. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. But whatever thou loose on earth is loosed in heaven. God give his church power. He's got a church. He brought the church in motion upon the day of Pentecost. No church under the Holy Ghost got here. But when the Holy Ghost got here, he built a church. And honey, he built a church with power. He built it with faith. He built it with fire. And there's a church tonight upon this rock. I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Give the Lord a good clap offering. Holy Ghost fell on the day of Pentecost. I can hear the Jews in Jerusalem, people around the world, said, let them alone. It'll soon blow over. Honey, it has. It's just about blown over the world. People of every denomination, every creed, every color, under every nation is receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost and the initial evidence of speaking in other tongues. And God has set power in the church, and the church has got power, and God wants the church to use that power. Clap your hands for the victory. Jesus made it clear in the book of Acts 1 and 8, you don't have no power until you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. You don't hold no power. You ain't got no keys to go in there and open no doors. Honey, but when you get the Holy Ghost, you got power, and you can knock on the devil's door and tell the devil, come out or I'll come in and get you. Come on and clap your hands. We got power in God. He said, I'll give you power to tread over sicknesses. I'll give you power over afflictions. I'll give you power to cast out devils, heal the sick, and cleanse the lepers. I'll give you power to raise the dead and preach the gospel. Come on, saints. Give the Lord another good clap offering. Church is not a real church until it gets the baptism of the Holy Ghost in the church. All nine gifts of the Spirit operating from the pulpit out in the congregation. The preacher casting out devils, healing the sick, cleansing the lepers, opening blind eyes, people getting out of wheelchairs, off of walkers, off of stretchers. I'll tell you tonight, Jesus said, the works that I do, a greater works can you do, because I go back to the Father. He said, if I go away, I'll come again. I'll receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Come on, there's a real church in the church. People, remember when Elijah, the false prophets of Baal had gathered around. They prayed nearly all day long. Nothing had took place. They called on God, but God hadn't done nothing. Their God was on a journey pursuing. He was dead. He was not with them. But old Elijah stepped out, prayed a 63-word prayer. And honey, fire come out of heaven and consumed the sacrifice. He was tapped into the real church. He knew his God was alive. He said, you put water in the barrels. You dig the trenches, because God is going to set this place on fire. I'll tell you, there's a few preachers that can pray a hole through the skies that can get fire out of heaven. Would you clap your hands? I feel the anointing. 12 disciples, thou art Peter, and upon this rock I'll build my church. And I'll let you get in the church. You got to get in the church, and the church has got to get in you. Honey, you can tend the church and shake every preacher's hand. You might as well shake a donkey's tail if you ain't saved. How many believe it? Say amen. My word, write your name on a barn door, is join a church and put your name on the roll, shake the preacher's hand without salvation. But I'll tell you, honey, there's a few churches that's a church, and it's got the anointing in the church. It's got the power of God in the church. I'll tell you what, they're casting out devils, healing the sick, the lames are walking, and the dumbs are talking. He's a blind eye opener. He's a lame leg healer. He's a leper cleanser. He's a dead man raiser. He's a gospel preacher, and his name is Jesus. Now give the Lord a good clap offering. Peter, I want to give you this power. I want to give you some of this. I want you to get in my church, and I want my church to get in you. Oh, glory. You know, I can remember when I come up and was reared in a denominational church, and everybody was quiet. Things started on time. We got out on time. And I mean on time. They set the clock and watched it. I don't care how the Spirit wanted to move. They turned out at a certain time. They operated by the watch. They operated by the clock. How many believe I'm telling you the truth? There's a lot of churches right now tonight that's watching its own program this morning. That they start on time. They get out a little early. They're out before dark. They say they're afraid. Since times have changed. Things are so wicked. We better turn. burn out early. Honey, where's your faith? If you got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, none of these things shall move me. Oh, glory to God tonight. I feel power that's in the church. And who's got the power? We got the power. The church has got the power. Use it where two agree on any one thing. That's me and you on your problems. It shall come to pass. Peter, you want to get in my church? I want my church to get in you. Thou art Peter, and upon this rock I'll build my church. That rock was Christ. That church has got to be built on Christ. If it ain't built on Christ, it ain't no church. What was Christ's church? Funny, there was miracles in Christ's church. There was miracles in Christ's church. He was a miracle worker. Oh, yes, he's turned the water to wine. Praise God, he built a church. He passed by the pool of Bethesda, and a man had been there 38 long years. He told him, "Wilt thou be made whole?" He said, "Sir, when the waters get troubled, I ain't got nobody to put me into the pool." He said, "You ain't got to get into the pool. All you got to do is rise, pick up your bed, and walk." Honey, that's the church. How many believe it? Give the Lord a good clap offering. I can see him getting a church member there beside that pool. Jesus got him a member. Got him a member. Oh, glory. And when he got them kind of members, somebody said, "They're all cripples." No, they ain't. Boy, when Jesus heals them, they ain't crippled no more. How many believe that? You couldn't run them off. You know why? God healed them. Honey, them that God heals, honey, they're healed. They ain't half healed. You can go to every doctor and take them pills. I'm not condemning it, but you'll die just the same. But when you come to God and God heals you, honey, you'll live. He that beeth upon me shall never die. Give the Lord a good cap offering. If you got cancer and you're a cancer patient, you can go to the doctor. They can cut it out. They can burn it out. But it'll come back someplace else if God don't heal it. But if God heals it, you will never hear from it again. If I had a cancer, I'd find me a prophet. I'd find me a man of God and tell that man of God, "Lay hands on me. I need to get healed." Oh, brother, he said, "Lay hands on the sick. Anoint them with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick. And the Lord shall raise them up." Now give Jesus a good cap offering. Ain't that wonderful? Got him a good church member by the pool of Bethesda. Went on down toward the pool of Siloam. I've been to all both of them, and threw mud in the man's eyes. Told him to go wash in the pool of Siloam. Said, "You'll come back seeing." He put the mud in his eyes. Somebody led him to the pool. He washed the mud out of his eyes and come back seeing. He picked him up another church member. Oh, glory. "Upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it." Honey, when Christ walked the sandy seashore of Galilee, he was a lame leg healer. He was a blind eye opener. He was a leper cleanser. He was a dead man raiser. Honey, he passed by the lepers and cleansed the lepers. No healing and no cure, but he healed everything that come to him. Now give Jesus a good cap offering. Wouldn't he have been something? Said, "Well, I'm sorry. When they come to Jesus, I'll have to send you home. That's one of the cases that's incurable." Maybe we've lost that case. Jesus never loses a case. He never loses a battle. I don't care if it's cancer and it's eating, and don't care where it's at. My Jesus can heal it. He can curse the roots of the cancer. The cancer will die and you will live. I've seen people in coma with sugar diabetes. There's such a man that they're sitting right there. His wife went into a coma, and the doctors diagnosed in the hospital. Oh, the nurses and told me and him when we got upstairs in intensive care, "She's clinically dead. She's clinically dead." I said, "Yes, we've come to pray." She said, "There's no use. She's clinically dead." I said, "Would you step out and let us pray for her?" Honey, faith. I got the faith. If you got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, you can move your mountain. You can pluck up your sycamore trees. Listen, God said, "I'll heal you." Now give the Lord a good cap offering. My, 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 my. How could you sit there and be so dry when I feel so juicy? I could run with Elijah. I could dance with the psalmist David. Honey, I'm in the church, and the church is in me. Give the Lord a good clap over it. This brother, Ted and I, when we was praying for his wife, she groaned. She flickered her eyes. The first time that any reflex had been from her, and they said she was dead. But we got a reflex, and I told him and told the nurse, I said, that man's wife will live and she won't die. Brother, are you the brother? It was your wife. Am I right? It was your wife.
Yes, you're right.
The doctors said, nurses said, she's clinically dead.
That's right.
She was in a coma, gone, but we prayed and God brought her back around, and she come on to, and she's out the hospital and gone home. Honey, Jesus is a healer. Let me tell you, man don't know everything, but my God knows it all. How many believe there's a church in a church? If you'll let God, he'll move that thing, and the Lord will heal you. Give the Lord a good clap over it. Glory, glory. A few days later, she was out, loose, going home. I went to the hospital, in one of the hospitals, and for a lady that was dying, would eat up with cancer in lungs and gone, no hope. And she was in a coma, been in a coma for days. And I asked them, could I go in and pray for her? They said, okay, go ahead. And the family, one of the daughters, went in with me. While I was praying, she'd been in a coma for 9 days. While I was praying, her eyes jumped open, and she spoke and said, who are you? I said, never mind who I am, but there's one that's bigger than I am that's standing at the foot of your bed. He's got his hand on your fevered brow. He walked in this room to curse your sickness and your diseases and your infirmity. He walked in here and spoke peace where there's no peace. He give life where there's no life. Honey, let me tell you, Jesus never loses a battle. He wins them all. Give the Lord a good clap over it. She come to. Hallelujah. Another case, I went in to one of the local hospitals, and when I got there, I was just kind of pressed my way on in intensive care, and got on in there, and the doctors was working on this lady, about three doctors and two or three nurses. And they said, who are you? I said, I'm her pastor, and I've come to pray for her. It won't take me but just a minute. He looked me straight in the eye, one of the head doctors, and said, you can pray if you want to, but says she's going to die just the same. I said, what? He said, you can pray if you want to, but that won't change one thing. Says she's going to die. I looked him straight in the eye. I said, look who's talking. I said, God gives and God takes. As long as there's breath, there's hope. I believe God's got some men that's got the faith of a grain of a mustard seed, can go behind closed doors and stay the hand of death and pray the prayer of faith. It shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise them up. Let me preach tonight. I've come to preach. Clap your hands. I feel some victory. She was in a coma. So I prayed for her, walked out of the room, went back by the next day, and opened the door. Went past that same doctor, and I said, Doc, how's she doing? He never answered me. He just kept walking. I know there was something either good or something bad. And I looked at him and walked on into the room. I'll never forget it, and the bed was empty. And the devil says, she died. I said, you're lying through your teeth. She didn't die. Hallelujah. When God's man touches the hem of Jesus' garment, they don't die, they live. Jesus said, he that believeth upon me, I shall never die. Though he were dead, yet shall he live again. Honey, he come to bring life and have it more abundantly. The devil come to steal. He come to kill. He come to destroy. But Jesus come walking the bill of ways at the fourth watch of the night. To speak peace under the waters, and the waters listened. Oh, let me preach. I feel God moving in this place tonight. I went back out, and the doctor seen me coming and went into another room. I asked one of the nurses, what happened to the lady that was in that coma yesterday in there? She said, I don't know, but some preacher come by. He prayed for her and said he hadn't hardly got out the hospital until she come to, and said she, when she come to and such, so strong and so good, we moved her down to her room today. Oh, glory to God. 3 days later, she come home. Honey, God's got some people, preachers and prophets that belongs to the church. I mean the real church. They're on the rock, and that rock is Christ. Give the Lord another clap offering. I'm going to preach faith tonight. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Listen to me. Before we minister to several people, bunches of them, that's here tonight to be healed. He's a healer. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Heard a preacher preaching on the radio the other day, and on one of the broadcasters, he said he only put healing in the church to start the church off and get it going. But said when the disciples died, said there's no more healing. Said healing died with the disciples. Healing went out when the disciples went out. Jesus, Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 8, I'll challenge any of them, and I'll stand on it, that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said, I'm the Lord thy God that changeth not. I'll put none of the afflictions upon you that I put upon the Egyptians, but I'll bring you forth with silver and with gold, and they shall not be one, a feeble one among your tribes. Listen, Jesus Christ is alive forevermore. Now give him another good clap offering. Peter, I want you in this church. Jesus seen one time, had a couch, taking a man down to a house where he was holding services. Brother, and they began, he was praying for multitudes, and they began climbing up on the house, couldn't get to him no other way. They began climbing up on top of the house, tearing the tiling off, raising the roof. They were lifting the roof off, began taking the tiling of the roof off where they could get close enough, they could see him. And I could hear that man groaning and say, I don't believe I'll ever make it to get there. Them old four boys that was on the four corners of that couch, you said, you just hold on and wait just a little bit. We'll get you to a man that can pray for you. We'll get you where Jesus is. We'll carry you to a church that's on that rock. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Let me preach. When you get to a real church, there's deliverance in that church. There's a blind eyes are being opened, and deaf ears are being unstopped. He's cursing cancers. The cancers are dying, and the people's living. That's the church. Without that, there's no church. Clap your hands. I feel the victory. They tore the tiling off and the roof off the house, dropped the man down in front of Jesus, and Jesus told him, said, I've never seen such great faith. No, not in Israel. Rise, pick up your bed and walk. He got him another church member. He got him another one. I see him going down towards Nain, passing through the gates one day, and there was a funeral procession going by, and there was a widow woman. There was a woman had her only son going out to bury him, and Jesus stopped that funeral procession and spoke and raised that boy from the dead. He got him another church member. He got him another church member. Oh, glory to God. He come to Lazarus' tomb. Lazarus had been dead 4 days. He walked into Bethany, and Mary and Martha met him. They said, Lord, if thou would only been here, thou brother not die. He said, if you'll only believe, you will see your brother rise again. They said, yes, Lord, it'll be the last day, the morning of the resurrection. Jesus said, I am the resurrection, the way, the truth, and the life. Honey, he is the resurrection. Clap your hands. Don't you feel the fire? You walk to that tomb. I was there a few months ago. Said Lazarus, called him by his first name. If he hadn't have said Lazarus, what, all that cemetery in Bethany would have come out of there a shouting and a praising God. He only wanted one. His name was Lazarus. He said, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus, come bouncing up them 25 steps until he got to the top. He was bound hand and foot. in great clothes. But Jesus backed off and said, now loose him and let him go. Honey, if you need loosening tonight, he'll loose you. He'll let you go. Clap your hands. Don't you feel a victory? Got him another church member. Mary Martha was there. Got two more church members. He loved them. Hallelujah. 11th chapter, he raised him from the dead. The 12th chapter of St. John. 11th chapter of St. John, he raised him from the dead. 12th chapter, if you notice, glory to God. The second verse, he had supper with Lazarus. You don't eat with dead people. Oh, glory. How many believe that? My God, he went to his house to prove that he was alive. He was all right. He was healed. Weren't nothing wrong with him. He got out and had supper with Lazarus, whom they'd buried. And before days, by that time, he'd only been stinking. But Jesus walked up to the tomb and said, Lazarus, come out of there. I'm going home with you. I'm going to go to your house. I'm going to have supper with you. Honey, when you get good and saved, Jesus will come to your house. I don't care if you make him a welcome guest. He'll come in. He'll abide in your house. Now give the Lord another a good clap offering. Mary and Martha was there when they had supper. They served. 12th chapter, 2nd verse, along about the 13th chapter of St. John, the 2nd to 4th verse, Jesus washed feet with Lazarus. Washed their feet, and Lazarus and them was there. Your live man can't wash feet. How many believe him? Somebody said, did they, talking about foot washing. They said, you know what foot washing is? I said, I believe I do. I've washed feet before. I said, Jesus said, if I wash your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. And if you don't wash one another's feet, you will have no part with me. Oh, they said foot washing is going in somebody's house and cleaning up the house and said making up the beds and cooking them a meal and carrying them a meal. I said, that's cooking. And that's house cleaning. Foot washing is foot washing. How many believe you got to wash? Jesus didn't lie. He showed him the feet. Oh, wash one another's feet. But bless God, old Lazarus, was it the foot washing? Give the Lord another cap offering. Got him some more good church members. Praise God for victory tonight. This is the way to build your church upon the rock. Jesus Christ, I'll build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I've seen people come here that was on crutches and on canes and had to die with emphysema in their lungs, maybe with cancers, heart conditions, all kind of diseases, holding them up under the arms, and they were staggering and trembling all over and cutting their clothes. They lost weight until the clothes were about to fall off them, and somebody lead them down the aisle on crutches or on a walker or on a cane, and we reach up and touch the hem of Jesus' garment, and they'll come off of them walkers and get off of them canes, honey, and get healed. Let me tell you something. That's the church. I don't care what you say. That's the church. That's the real church where the lame is a-walking and the dumb is talking and the blind seeing and the lepers are being cleansed and the dead's being raised and the gospel is being preached. How many believe I'm preaching tonight? Amen. Hell, a man brought into my service one night in one of my evening services, and he was 11th in line. I'll never forget it. And a lady come up and said, Brother Dobbs, would you pray for my husband? Said, he's dying. And I looked in, and the rescue mission had brought him up outside, and they paid him to bring him here. And the boys were standing at the front door, and she said, he's dying. Said, he just can't get a pulse beat. And I started to step out of line and say, roll the stretchers on up here. But Jesus checked me and said, don't you pray. Don't you pray. And I thought to myself, oh, Lord, don't let that man die in my church. I've suffered enough persecution. I'm another Job. I'm the second Job in this area. Don't let me suffer this persecution of this man dying in my prayer line. And Jesus said, don't you touch him right now. Oh, glory. And I stood there and looked at him back to him. I said, lady, I'm sorry. The Lord said I couldn't pray. She said, you mean you're not going to pray for my husband? I said, not right now. And about time I started to pray for somebody else, she screamed and said, there's no use praying now. He's dead. He's dead. There's no pulse beat. Jesus said, now pray. Now pray. Oh, glory. I can see him. He could have got to Lazarus' tomb early, but he waited a little late. He wanted to build faith. Oh, praise God. He wanted to build a church. How could he build a church? But by faith. Come on, saints. I'm preaching what you need. Listen. I said, now, Jesus said, tell him to bring him on now. I said, Lord, they say the man's dead. He said, I raised Lazarus from the dead. I raised him up. I raised the boy from the dead at the gate called Nain. I raised him up from the dead. He said, Peter raised the dead. Oh, glory, upon this rock I'll build my church. And Peter wouldn't have belonged to that church if he hadn't raised the dead. He went over to Dorcas's house, and they were over there in the 8th, 9th chapter, along there, the book of the Acts of the Apostles. And he went over to her house, and they were showing the good alms deeds where Dorcas had built clothes and made clothes for a lot of people. And when he got there, Dorcas was dead and stretched out on the stretchers. He put all that unbelief outside that room. He gathered old Peter and James together and called them inside and shut the door. And upon that rock, he built a church, and he prayed life back into Dorcas and raised Dorcas from the dead and said, now feed Dorcas. Come on, saints. I feel the anointing of God in this place. Apostle Peter raised the dead. I'm going to get you right where I want you. Hold on just one moment. Paul was a long-winded preacher, long about the 20th chapter of the book of the Acts of the Apostles. And he preached to midnight one night. He was nearly long-winded as me. Amen. But he preached about midnight, and there was a young man sitting in the window up on the third story of that place where he's preaching, in that little auditorium in that big room. And he had the window pulled up. It was a little hot. And Peter was really preaching. Paul was really preaching that night. And that young man stooped over and went to sleep and fell out the window and fell down from three stories on the sidewalk and killed himself. Fell out and went to sleep. Fell out the window on the sidewalk. Old Peter had something a lot of preachers didn't have. A lot of preachers said that was good enough for him by him going to sleep. He ought to fell out the window. Oh, but Peter had more than that. He had love. He belonged to the real church. You know what he done? He went down them stair steps, three flights of steps, and got down on that sidewalk and got over that a young man that his spirit and his breath had left out of his body, and he was dead. He prayed life. Paul did. Back into that young man. My God. Paul belonged to the church. My God, come on, saints. I'm preaching tonight. Oh, glory. Upon this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell can't shake it apart. You can't tear it down because it's built on the rock. Let me tell you this in closing. While my singers and my organist comes, nothing but nothing could get me out of this kind of a church. Now, this is the church where Jesus Christ saves the lost, reclaims backsliders. And I mean, it'll stop you drinking, you fussing and a cussing. It'll stop you dipping and a stipping and a fighting and going on carousing. How many people preaching the truth tonight? My God, wake up. Hallelujah. When you get in the church and the church gets in you, honey, you become alive. You're alive. You're resurrected, walking in the newness of life in that same church. When you join that church, you join in Jesus' church. If you never join a church, and I'm for church joining, but if you never join a church this side of heaven, join Jesus' church and get your name in the Lamb's book of life. My God, be a child of the Holy Ghost. Clap your hands for the victory. Glory. Upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shows me why hell has got its gates. Them that's in there was screaming would run out and get away. But hell has got gates. Shut them in. But upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against this kind of church. How many believe the churches of the living God's going on? It's going up. It ain't going down. Somebody say the church world's going down. Honey, I got news for you. The church world's going up. It's going up in the rapture. How many believe Jesus went away? Wait, if I go away, I'll come again. I'll receive you unto myself. Where I am, there you may be also. Honey, he's coming back for a church without a spot and without a wrinkle. And if you got your name on your Father's book, he'll take you in the rapture when he come back. Give the Lord a good clap for it. 12 disciples. Only two of them raised the dead. Peter and Paul Rest of them was good preachers, handpicked evangelists, but there's something they didn't have that them other two boys had, and that was power with God. Power to raise the dead, cleanse lepers, and preach the gospel. How many feel it tonight? Why didn't them other 10 boys, they were disciples, they were handpicked, they didn't have what Peter and Paul had. They raised the dead. They cleansed lepers. Oh, glory. Clap your hands. I feel the victory tonight. How many preachers that's listening to me right now, know that I got scripture to back up what I'm preaching, but he don't have scripture to back up what he's preaching? How many believe that? You don't have power until you receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Clap your hands. I feel the victory tonight. Casting out devils, cleansing lepers, raising the dead, and preaching the gospel to the poor. Glory.